Well, good morning. Welcome to Financial Freedom Show. I'm CS Sudhir. Mr. Shant Raju has posted a question on the Financial Freedom app. He says, what are the various things to be considered while purchasing a property, residential property? In fact, when it comes to purchasing a residential property, I want you to basically look at three aspects. So let me cover the first one. That's about affordability. Many a times we get into a trap, in fact a debt trap, by purchasing a property which is beyond our affordability. By doing that, you put yourself into a debt trap. You will be, you know, kind of, you know, you'll not be able to manage paying your home loan EMIs. You'll borrow money for your down payment. You'll get into trouble. That's why I want you to think about three aspects when it comes to affordability. Number one, down payment. Make sure you have enough money for down payment. If you are purchasing a property worth crore rupee, you must have at least 25 lakh rupee for down payment. This is important because this 25 lakh includes your registration expenses and the down payment amount. Sometimes it goes up to 30%. On top of it, you'll also have your expenses for interiors and all that, right? The furnishing expenses. So otherwise, down payment is something you need to be very, very particular about. Number two is EMI amount. Can you really afford the EMI amount? Whatever it is, like, you know, it should not happen that your monthly salary is 50,000 and your EMI is 45,000. Then you'll be into a trap. Make sure your monthly EMI is not more than 50% of your monthly income. If it is more than 50% of your monthly income, then you will not be able to service it because you have other commitments to make, right? You have got to pay your, you know, grocery bill, you have to pay your, you know, healthcare expenses, your health insurance payment, your kids' school fees, things like that. Number three, the maintenance. What is the maintenance? In case of apartments, villas, these days we end up with paying a lot of maintenance. You know, a 1,000 square foot flat will cost you about 4,000 or 5,000 rupee just monthly maintenance amount. Can you really afford that on top of your home loan? This is something to be asked. The next thing you need to worry about is the basic steps around the location, the title deed, all that. So the location is very important. Many a times we buy something because it is cheap, but then will you be able to manage your office travel, your kids' school travel and all that? You know, whenever you're purchasing a property, you have an opportunity to choose the one which is very convenient for you. At the same time, it should also be a nice place, a nice locality. If you get into some locality which is not good, then you will suffer. I don't want that to happen. So I want you to make sure that you choose the location which is convenient, not just for you, but your family members, because they'll have to spend a lot of the time there, the schools, the you know, education institutions in that around, in the surrounding should be good. That's again very important. Same time, you should also check the clear title, the title deed of the property. If the property has got some disputes, litigation, then you'll suffer throughout your life. And the last but not the least, very important one is cost benefit analysis, which means the amount of money you are investing in the property, the interest you will pay on that, and the rental amount you would have otherwise paid if you rent this place, what is the difference? How much are you going to actually save or spend extra? You'll have to think about all that. At the same time, you'll also consider the appreciation aspect. Like, you know, what kind of appreciation you expect over a period of 10 years or 15 years. That's again very important. If you don't consider all these aspects and invest in a residential property, you will get into a trap and that's not good for you. Also on Financial Freedom App, we have about 85, 86 courses on personal finance, career, business, farming and life skills. Also for Republic TV viewers, we have an interesting offer. If you enter the referral code Freedom Show, as you see on the screen, you will get rupees 2000 scholarship to access all these courses. Please make use of this offer. And if you have any questions related to any of these topics, please post your questions on the Financial Freedom App. I will answer your questions in my next episode. Thanks for watching. Be wise, get rich.